Have you ever tried to delete records in Airtable? Doing it manually isn't always the most fun. Now, this isn't a practice that we do a lot of, but there are those occasions where you do need to delete records. So, if you could build an automation to do that, wouldn't that be ideal? Well, that's exactly what I'm going to be breaking down in this video, so if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I am the owner at Gap Consulting, where I'm going to help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools. The number one tool that you could start to master today that would really help reclaim that time is automation. There are a number of automation tools, and we talk about all of it here on this channel. But if you're new to automation, the best place to start is my free automation training. I'm going to teach you the building blocks so that you can start leveraging the power of automation, reclaiming your time, and eliminating those mundane, repetitive tasks that you do day in and day out. If that's of interest, check out that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video where we are talking about how to use automation to delete records in Airtable. Now, if you follow this channel for any amount of time, you'll know that, as I said in the beginning, there are very few times where you actually want to delete records. Most of the time, it makes perfect sense to just archive data. There are a lot of simple ways to do that. You can add checkboxes that remove your records from a particular view. Most of the time, we don't want to delete data because if we created it, there's generally a reason why, and hanging on to that information costs us nothing. So it's a lot easier just to remove it from a particular view, but still keep that data just in case we need it in the future. However, there are those times where you might have created a record accidentally, or for some other reason, you just don't want that data anymore. So I do want to preface by saying, generally you won't want to delete, but if you're in that 10% where, yeah, occasionally you do actually have real reason to delete your data, check out this automation. So the structure that I've built here for us is pretty straightforward. We're looking at a financial database where I've got client information, so pretty simple, just name and email. And of course, our clients are buying things from us, so they link to income. Flipping into my income table, you can see that we sell two different types of services. We have service one or service two, and they carry these different amounts, amount of 1,000 or 1,500. Of course, we also record the date that something was paid, and then there's that link to client, who is it that bought this thing from us? And then we also have a link to our payroll, because we only incur payroll costs, especially if we're using contract labor, 1099 employees, we only incur those costs when we sell something, right? So for example, let's say that we provided a service here. Service one requires Art to do something for us, or service two requires two other team members. Here we have Barry or Carl. We'll look at this a little bit more in the next table. But I've also built a button here that's going to allow me to automatically delete the payroll that has been linked to a particular income. Now, it's not enough just to delete the linked relationship. We also need to delete the actual record that was created in the payroll table. So flipping into the payroll table, you see that we first grouped by the income field. So we have three different things that we've sold so far in our database. Service one to Gareth on 6/5, service one to Gareth on 6/8, and service two to Gareth on 6/10. And depending on the type of service, well then we have different payroll costs. And so you see here that this particular payroll record was created due to the amount of $500 and it's due to Art, probably because of the structure that we've set up in our income and payroll table. Same thing here, we sold service one again, $500 to Art. But here we sold service two, and you'll see that we have a $250 payroll to Barry and a $400 payroll to Carl that's incurred because of that sale, that service two sale. So why would we ever want to delete these records? Well, if for some reason we had something in our income table that we did not intend to create, then of course we don't want to incur those payroll costs. It doesn't make sense just to archive those costs. We need to remove them entirely. Because if we didn't sell the thing, or if we didn't sell the same thing that we stipulated here, let's say for example, this wasn't service two, it was service one, and we made a mistake when we put it into the database, Well then, we want to make sure that we don't incur those charges. We don't want to pay to Barry and to Carl if, in fact, we didn't actually sell this thing. So this is exactly why we have this button here to delete the payroll, and this is going to trigger our automation to find out what payroll records those are and delete them entirely. But before I get to that, I also want to point out that I've built an automation inside of Airtable that allows me to create payables. So popping into this automation really quickly, you can see that when certain conditions are met, namely that there's an income record in our income table that has a type, it has an amount, it was paid on a specific day, that means the day wasn't empty, but most importantly, the payroll is empty. So basically this is saying, if we ever incur a new record in our table that does not already have payables linked to it, then that will trigger this automation. And we've used some conditional actions here. In the case where it's service one, you'll see that we create a single payable record, link it to Art here in the amount of $500. Or in the case where it is service two that we sold, well then we're going to create a payable record for Barry in the amount of $250, and we're also going to create a payable record for Carl in the amount of $400. So just checking this out right here, if I were to disconnect the link here to these two payroll elements, let's just delete them, well then our automation's gonna pick up, it's gonna say, hey, this is service two, I'm gonna create two new payable records back here in the payroll table. But we don't like this. Because I broke that link, these two payroll records that were originally created are now just floating out in limbo. So a better way, rather than deleting the link, is to delete those payable records through an automation, and that's exactly what we're going to be talking about here. So let's go ahead and manually delete those so that we have a nice clean database, and now we're going to pop into Make. Now you may have heard me say before that I recommend Zapier for newbies to automation. I do feel like it's a little bit easier to start with Zapier and to start within that software. The guardrails are there for you, they'll keep you in line, and you don't have to worry about getting too far in the weeds. Integromat, now Make, is a much more complicated product, but it allows for some more advanced automation. So I need to use it. Unfortunately, Zapier in this particular case is not possible. So popping into our scenario here, it doesn't matter so much what the trigger is. In our case, I've built a button using a webhook. Then I'm going to find the record that triggered the automation in Airtable. Then I'm going to perform an iterator. Everything that happens after the iterator will happen for every record that goes through the iterator. And this will make sense in a moment because of the fact that I might have multiple records in my payroll table that need to be deleted. I need to perform that iterator that allows my automation to delete each one of the records that it finds. And then the last step here is just deleting the record. So let's go ahead and pop into this automation and take a closer look. First and foremost, I have my webhook here. If you've not used a webhook before, it's fairly straightforward. The URL is automatically created for us, and we can copy this to our clipboard. Then we can pop back into Airtable, and we will create a button. And the first part of the button is where we paste in that URL. So the section that I've highlighted here is the webhook that was created for me by Make. Now after that, I want to add a parameter. ?recID=, and this is the name of the variable that I am identifying. I've used recID, you can call it record ID. What I want to pass through is the ID of the record that pushed the button. Then after this, I bring in the record ID. This is a formula inside of Airtable that allows us to call upon the record ID for any record. So that when I push this, this button push is completely unique based on the record that I selected it for. If I were to select that for the first record, I would get the first record's ID. If I do it for the second one, I get the second record's ID, etc. Now popping back into Make, I am going to look up the record in Airtable that passed that ID. So we use the Airtable module get a record. There will only be one record that pushes the button every time, so we only look for one record here. And I'm looking in my base, in this case the base is named delete records. I look in my income table, and here's where I bring in the variable that I created in the trigger. So I called mine rec ID, whatever you name your variable, that's what's gonna get passed in right here. All we're saying is find that record in the income table that just pushed the button. Next step is to add that iterator. If you haven't done this before, simply pop in the tools here and you can find iterator right here. The iterator has to come after the search for the record. And what we're gonna use in the iterator is whatever array we found in the previous step. So in our second module here, notice the module number is 3. So in module 3, we found an income record, and inside of that record, we have an array, a link to many, one or more, payroll records. And so that's what we're passing along here. And what this means is we are going to perform the functions that follow the iterator for every single instance that we found a record in the payroll link. So in the case where we perform this for service 2 that would have two different payroll instances, the iterator will allow whatever happens next to be performed on every single one of those payroll instances. So if we're deleting a record, which we are here, we will delete every record that we found that is linked to the payroll that we identified in the income record from our get a record module here. So the last part here is to add this step into make. It is simply delete a record. And all it's gonna ask us is, well, what base am I looking for that in, and what table does that record live in? And then we need to use the record ID. Don't use the record ID that came out of this particular step here. Use the record ID that we are iterating on out of the iterator. Otherwise, you might have an array here, and this will only delete one record at a time, and that's why we need to make sure to use the iterator value. That's how we set this up. Let's go ahead and take it out for a spin. Be sure to save your automation and turn it on before testing it out. And now we can flip back into Airtable. Now, before we test this out, let's first turn off our automation that will create new payrolls. It's gonna be a little difficult if we are trying to test out deleting payrolls and creating payrolls all at the same time. So first, let's turn off our create new payables automation. And now we're just gonna test the delete payroll automation. So when I click this button, delete payroll, it's gonna open up our webhook, and we can come back into Airtable just in time to see that where there were two payroll records, they are now gone. But not only have we deleted the linked relationship, if we go into the payroll table, we see that sure enough, those payroll records are gone. Those two that we had, the one that was linked to Barry and the one that was linked to Carl, they're completely gone. So let's go ahead and turn our payables back on now. Our payable creation automation. We'll then flip back to our income table, and let's see if we can get this to properly create the two payables. So let's imagine a scenario where we say, all right, this was service 2, we record that income, perfect. Our automation is gonna pick that up and create new payable records for Barry and Carl, as it just did. And now we might realize, we made a mistake. This is actually supposed to be service 1. I didn't mean to create two payroll records, one for Barry, one for Carl. I meant for this to just create one single payroll record for Art. So how do we get rid of those old ones? That's exactly what we're gonna test now. We can set this to be service 1 instead. Now I say delete payroll and go back to Airtable, and I see that my automation triggered. It deleted the payrolls for Barry and Carl, and then my other automation picked up that this was now for service 1, and it created a payroll record for Art. And we can flip into the payroll table and confirm all of that. The payroll records for Barry and Carl have been once again deleted, and I've created a proper one for Art. If I make another mistake, no problem. Turn that to service 2, delete the payroll again, go back to Airtable. We delete the payroll for Art. Our automation is going to pick up on this, create something for Barry, create something for Carl, and we're all set. And we can check our payroll table again, and we see that everything is lined up properly. I know we went fast in this video, but I hope you got a ton of value from it. Remember, don't go deleting records by default. There should be a very specific reason for you to delete a record. Most of the time, archiving that data is gonna be more than sufficient, but for the 10% of cases where you actually want to delete something, I hope you can use this very automation to do it. Below this video, I'm going to be sharing my link for Make. If you don't already use Make and this has encouraged you to start using it, check out that referral link. It will give you a 30-day free trial on their pro plan. And be sure to subscribe to this channel so that you can stay up to date with no code and no code news. And I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts, we have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.